Now I'm going to add another element relative display here just briefly, and as I do, keep an eye on the unit of measure. This is something that does cause, I think, a bit of confusion. I'm going to go ahead and search for through the database that I've been working with and through this CBT, and I'm going to find just the mixing tanks, because what I'd like to show you is the level on those mixing tanks. When I select this, when I select either one, I can now go ahead and create an element relative trend based on what I've currently selected. So I'll choose to do an element relative search here. As you can see, we've picked up that mixing tank one. And what we're interested in is the level. As you can see, level is currently shown in meters. And if we take a look at the definition in AF, I'll go over and switch over to a different virtual machine here. If we look at this generic tank template, that's how we define level in terms of meters. So far, so good, right? Well, here's the surprise. Watch what happens when I display this in Process Book. You may have already noticed this in your last exercise. Here we go. I'm specifying level. Let's go back and do, say, a one-day retrieval. And what I'm seeing is not meters. What I'm seeing here is liters, of all things. That's kind of odd. Let me see what happens when I switch to mixing tank 2. Well, for that one, I am seeing meters, which is even more disturbing. Why am I showing meters and liters and not what we had just shown when we looked at the definition in AF? Well, it's because we're defaulting to showing you the definition of engineering units as it is on the PI server, not on the AF server. That's the default behavior here. And one of the ways to verify that is, watch, if I go ahead and select that trend and I'll go into my point attributes, if I scroll down, you can see the engineering units for the tag that's referred to here. That's the tag that we're currently looking at. As you can see, we're seeing the name of the tag in the PI server, not the name of the AF reference. But that has liters as its engineering units. And if I were to switch over to mixing tank 2 here, and I do the same thing, now that engineering units is going to be meters. So as you can see, what we're doing is we're interrogating the engineering units field from the PI server, not the AF server. And that's not altogether what you would want. As I mentioned before, I believe, the PI server's engineering units is really kind of arbitrary. It's an open field. You can put anything you want in there, and it really doesn't have any impact when it comes to conversions. So let me show you how you can change that. If you want to show a specific unit of measure, what I can do is I can edit this, add a semicolon, and then add the unit of measure abbreviation that we use in AF. Now, if you want to know what that is, you'd have to go out and look up your unit of measures in AF. So let me demonstrate. You see, this just came up now. I'm showing meters for mixing tank 1 and mixing tank 2. Now, I don't know if you noticed that, but the value didn't change. It's still showing 85 for the one and 64 for the other. And that's because when I specified to use the AF unit of measure, it actually didn't do any conversion at that point, because up to that point we were just looking at the unit of measure from PI. And in fact, when you take a look at the definition of that level, it is defined as meters. So because I've used the same engineering unit as it's defined, I'm not going to see any conversion at all. Now, as I mentioned, if you need to know what these abbreviations are, you can just go into the unit of measure. You can go out and, you know, look for the value you're looking for, and then just look at the abbreviation. So that's the abbreviation you're going to use. Now I'm going to demonstrate this by doing two more. Let's look at what this would look like as centimeters and then as kilometers. And I can do that by going back to my Process Book machine here. And now I'll go into build mode. I'm going to modify this such that the abbreviation is now going to be in centimeters. So instead of showing this in meters, now we're going to get a conversion that's a genuine mathematical conversion. As you can see right here, this is now coming in as centimeters instead of as meters. If I switch over, you can see that as now centimeters, and it's labeled as centimeters as well, as you can see right here. And it may be obvious, but now if I go and change this to kilometers, we'll get the same result. So this will now convert. Now we're looking at this in terms of kilometers. It's labeled as kilometers, and it's doing the conversion for me. So that's how you'd make use of the changing of the unit of measure. There we go. Now we're back to our original 85 and around 64. Oh, and incidentally, just so you remember, when you do these conversions, you are going to have to make sure that you maintain the same class of unit of measures as the original. So, you know, these classes, here's all the different classes in length. I can do a conversion to any of these, including that one that I created myself earlier in class, a rod. I can go ahead and specify that I like to see this in rods because rod is in the same class as the length unit of measure. There we go. Now we're reporting that in my user-defined unit of measure there that has all the right conversions because we've set up the correct mathematical conversion ratios in the unit of measure database.